So we're going to be looking at all the fullbacks in FC24 to figure out who you should be getting. Obviously, it won't include any evolutions, unfortunately, because we have no way of doing that unless I go through every evolution that is available right now and what has been available in the past. Now, I would say there has been some very, very good ones, so let me know in the comment section below what evolutions you've got in your team that are defenders. So if you're looking to improve your team, make sure you're heading over to lootbar.gg. They are the best and most reliable coin service you can find. Also with the best 24-hour manual customer service that you physically cannot find anywhere else. But before finishing on lootbar.gg, make sure you are using the code JT11, 8% off your first ever transaction, and then 5% off every time after that. Once you've gone through the payment, you'll be able to get your coins within the next 24 hours, absolutely guaranteed. Also, with the code, you'll be able to get 5% more coins on every transaction. Make sure you do click the link either in the description or down in the comment section below. Now, the obvious ones. We've obviously got the team of the year. I still think the team of the year fullbacks this year have been amazing. Frimpong and Teo from the men's side are two of the best fullbacks we've had for a long time. I've loved Trent and Robbo over the years. Obviously, we started off with Dani Alves, Marcelo, and I think it was them two, really. Dani Alves and Marcelo was quite a while. Then, obviously, we've had some others prior to that. But these are incredible because, let alone this, we've had the Playstyle Pluses introduced this year, which I think they've done a spectacular job with this team of the year throughout the whole of it, to be honest. To keep them relevant is amazing. Then we have the likes of Ferland Mendy. I don't think anybody can argue with him. He still is one of the best cards that you can physically get in the game. He is still, I really want to know the price of him actually, because he has just had card after card after card. He's still coming in at 4.5 million coins. That is absolutely nuts to see. 93 rated. We do have previous versions as well. Obviously, I would go a kind of a different card rather than the 87 now, but that is just purely down to my want of a higher rated team. It doesn't necessarily mean anything. You could literally have a team of 87s if they've got the right stats and the right play styles, then they're still going to be excellent regardless, unless they've gone from silver to 87. Then sometimes it can get a bit sticky. Moving on. Teo Hernandez has got multiple versions as well. We do have the Dynasties. We have an Inform. And to be honest, right now, I'd probably go into an A-plus at the minimum. But I did want to go through the team of the seasons before we kind of get any further, because this is where it really changes the game, because we have got triple play style pluses. So if I get all of the team of the seasons that we currently have at the moment, just up here, so we've got a few of them. To be fair, we've got actually more than I thought. Is that everybody? That is a lot of team of the season. So White is from this Prem team of the season. McCabe is an SBC. Teze, I believe, was from the objective. And then the rest is kind of lives and then also the plus cards, I want to say. And then we do have Estepinha as well. I was going to say there was another one because we do have a moment as well. So if we was to go in and have a look at, obviously, some of the team of the seasons, what we've got, Ben White is the first one coming up. With him, he has got the triple play style plus of intercept, whipped pass, and long ball. Now, depending on how you utilize your right back, whether you want them overlapping, whether you want them just staying at a right back, will depend on then what play style pluses you want and kind of what stats you need as such, really. Fullbacks are always good with pace, defending, physical, a bit of dribbling, and a bit of passing. Shooting, I'm not too fussed about. Everybody could have below 50, and it doesn't really matter. But as long as they've got the rest of them, that is the kind of basis of them. And as you can see, pretty much every version of these cards, 90 pace, 88, 90, 88, 90. You've got so many 90 paces. Then you look at the defending. You've obviously got then the 90, 85, 88. And obviously chemistry styles do help as well. Physicality is kind of on that lower end, depending on what you want. For instance, with a Ben White, the chemistry style people are going to go with is either a shadow or an anchor. Shadow for just the out and out pace. And then you get more defending on him. 96, 97 is a very good and basic right back we've got right now. So if I was to think that, okay, I want an overlapping fullback. Rapid could be a shout. That's always a nice one for anybody overlapping. It's what I personally like on the wing. You could go quick step, technical. They would all be a decent one to have a running play style plus. Then you want something like a whipped pass or a long ball pass or an incisive, because a passing one is decent as well. You're trying to split up the right back because you don't necessarily need a full defensive anticipate, intercept, block. You don't need all of them because you have got the flexibility of having your centre-backs be in that absolute anchor point. And then you want a defensive one. So Ben White, unfortunately, has two of the three, which I still think is very good. If it was to look at someone like McCabe, just because she's an SBC and you can control if you actually get her or not, rapid, relentless, long ball. So again, missing out on just that one key one of having a defender or a defensive playstyle plus. I really don't like relentless. I just don't think at this point in the game it really matters. Another one that is an SBC, you've obviously got Vasquez, who is a live card. He only has two playstyle pluses, which definitely puts him at the lower end of the category. We then have Robinson, also he can go up in rating as well. Robinson has got the double as well with rapid and block, again missing out on just having that passing orientated one. Teze, I want to say has two? No, he has three. Whipped, intercept, block. That's probably one of the better ones, to be honest, and can be evolutions into the live team of the season to make him a 91. Also, with that, he does get an upgrade as well. So, for instance, if he does get his double upgrade with PSV, he would technically be 93 rated, not 92. So, always decent. Charles is the highest rated currently left back. Obviously, from Chelsea, we've got 84,000 for the whipped pass, intercept, and block. So we can kind of see the pattern we've got going on. One of my favourites is going to be Estupiña. He has been fantastic throughout this season, and most definitely, he deserved a big card upgrade. He's got the slide tackle, the whipped pass, and unfortunately, the long ball pass, which just is what it is, unfortunately. Udol is another SBC. We've had a lot of fullback SBCs in the past couple of days. We've got slide tackle, intercept, and then finally we have got Dest. Oh no, in fact, we've got Dest and we've got Klaus as well. So Dest got whipped past, relentless, intercept, kind of what we expected, to be honest. And then we have got the likes of Klaus. Now Klaus, big, big expectations for him. He is a live card as well, so can go up, but unfortunately can't go in that evolutions. Again, with the relentless, which is just that little bit unfortunate, but you can go with the anchor for him to make that physicality go up as well, as pace already hits that 99. Now, in terms of right backs, I don't think at this moment in time we see a single S card, unfortunately. So what I would personally go with, S plus card. I would personally go along this sort of route. So these two would definitely come down, and it's why I wanted to do team of the season first, because we have got some decent cards, but I think for me, it would be looking something like that. Because then you've got the bases. You've got to then think, if I want to go with a Jesus Navas, does he go in here? Because half of the time with these kind of categories, a lot of players do fit into the S category. But there's very few that fit into that S plus. And normally, with the S plus, it is very hard to break through. It takes that absolute monster of a left back, right back to really get in there. So for me, if I was looking at Galazos, it would be Cafu and also Roberto Carlos being the two main front runners there. If I was to go for anybody else, Carlos Alberto, arguably centre-back, right-back, but I really like him as a right-back at this moment in time with the centre-backs that we have now as well. If I was kind of looking across the board as well, I'd probably say at the moment that's about it, but we will soon see. With Alberto, he does have two versions as well. Alexandro, I think quite easily an S, quite easily. He does have the ability as well, if you haven't done him on anybody else, to go into a showdown winners too, which would make him into a 91 as well, because he has already had that boost, whipped pass and jockey. Now, everybody else doesn't have any sort of triple play star plus. They all have either double or single. Rolfo is in this list. You could argue between her, because I think she is very good as a centre mid, but I do think she is absolutely top of her class. She is still absolutely brilliant in the game. Bonpasta would easily go in there. Bakker, I would say, is slightly coming down now. She was S plus for quite some time, but now is definitely coming down, and I'd probably go with the A plus now for her 90 as well. When we look at some of the others, it seems to be that I just wanted as many Carlos Alberto cards as possible. Don't know how they snuck in. We've obviously got the other Roberto Carlos, and I'd say the base version as well is starting to really come down. Same with Cafu, still a very, very good card, but I think they're now split into what actually you would want in the game. And it's quite funny because we had, what is it? It was future stars that, like, it took it to a next level. Like, we actually got some really decent cards. Baudet and Lewis, both very, very good. Slightly off their kind of peak now, in my opinion. They're starting to really kind of fall below the waistline. But they were very good once they came out. We then got Fantasy or Ultimate Birthday. I think it was Fantasy first. And then again, they went up absolutely crazy. Like, we got Mattison, who is an easy S. Acuna, I'm not necessarily thrilled with. Singo as an SBC. We got Yan Cueto, Pedro Porro. I think they were some of the best cards that we could really see. And then we went up again. We went into Ultimate Birthday, and it really, really, again, started to take it to the next level. Obviously, we've still got a few in there with Cancelo. I think he's kind of past it. Same with Navas. Even Walker, to be honest, his pace just doesn't hold him up anymore, and we are still desperate for that next upgrade for him. A couple of Thunderstrucks managing to get in here. Emerson's managed to get in as well. Then we kind of keep scanning down. We've obviously got Trent. Trent, unfortunately for me, was absolutely horrendous as a right back. And I don't know if it's purely on the basis that I really like the shapeshifter center mid version. As a defender, just they really just doesn't do very well. He needed a massive upgrade to make himself even slightly more relevant, in my opinion. But then we do have Ndogi. I thought he was absolutely brilliant as well. If you could evolution him as well, he was going to be absolutely incredible. But then, like I said, we go on to some of the ultimate birthdays. Now we got the 5-4s. Some with a 5-5. I don't even know if anybody got a 5-5, but they all got at least a 4-5 or a 5-4, depending on if they had a double version or not. We got one of the best prices for an SBC in Reece James. Still to this day, fantastic, but definitely now we're looking towards more of a team of the season. And you could argue you could bring everybody down and say James isn't on the level of a team of the season. But with some of them having the relentless, I don't even class it as a triple play style plus. They know what they're doing. It's triple, but technically there's only two that really count in that. Then we obviously have a few more. Bellerin starting to really hit the low levels. I'd say Gossens now is kind of, even with Frankowski, just not quite at that level. Niles I actually really liked, even though he is very, very cheap. I still think he could definitely do something. We have Bowie, really impressed with him. Caldrado could go one up. Grimaldo wasn't terrible, but again, like with Trent, he is just so much better. And it's kind of the same with Acuna. In that center mid role with the shapeshifter, the 5-5, they are going to be fantastic. Sakina, you could argue she's still in there. The price kind of matters a little bit, but she was still fantastic. Ashley Cole, quite an easy Galazzo in there. You can and did evolve him into a 93 as well with a Galazzo. Was it the Galazzo icon or the Galazzo show that let you put some of the icons into it? We also then had Lazarazu, Scott, and I think did I already put Bonpasta in there? I would go something along the lines of that, in my opinion. Loved Bonpasta. I think stat-wise, very underrated. And even the same for Lazarazu. We also then have two Chilwells, because why not? Two is better than one, apparently. I would kind of be looking more towards an A+ now, whereas Mukiele was phenomenal. Very, very good right back. And again, has the ability to go into that showdown, which is just fantastic in itself. So you can go from a 91 to a 92 with a great boost there. Like, we're looking at them stats. That is some hard-hitting stats. You go with the anchor on him, if I can even find it. Why can I never find it when I want it? There it is. 99, 95, 96. Rapid whipped pass. It's a beautiful, beautiful card. And especially for what was the cost? 59,000. I mean, that just kind of says it all. 59,000 card, 92 rated with a showdown. Beautiful. If then we finish off the rest, we've got Alphonso Davies. Could do with the upgrade. I could argue that he could be pushed back, but I think he's just nicking it in there. Lahm, as a right back, I'd go more towards an A+. Zanetti, we have got multiple versions as well. Honestly, I really need to look at these cards before I add them. I must have just not seen him. I'd put him on the same category, in my opinion. I think him and Lahm together, so much better in the middle, in my opinion. Same as the likes of like how Petit was. He can have a left back. He's better in that CDM role. And then somebody like a Mascherano, much prefer him as a CDM than a center back. Then we do have Zambrotta, who again is absolutely fantastic. And I think that is going to be my list for today. Let me know down below what you would agree or disagree with and who is your right back. And like I said at the start, any evolutions, leave them down below. And if you want to check the videos on screen, I'll catch you all for the next one. Peace.